I've been building a terminal development environment for the past decade, working as a dev and ops engineer in various roles from consultant through team and tech lead roles to an architect of the company's product. I like effective, efficient, and fun tools working together for a fast and smooth experience, and while most of the bits I'm going to show here were already in existence, in some areas I had to hack my way through. In one case, I even built my own open source to solve a problem that I and many others now use. We'll get back to that, but for now, let's start with an overview starting from the basics, and we'll slowly build it up in layers to every bit I use to create my perfect environment. I use Wezterm. I like its simplicity, speed, the way it can render visuals from icons through emojis and all the way to images in the terminal. This is Yazi, by the way, showing these things beautifully inside Wezterm. Wezterm is super easy to configure, it does everything I need, it includes quick changes from time to time when I adjust it for videos like this one for example. The look is minimal, nothing fancy, and it fits every use case I have. Here's a list of images where the folders and the image icons are nerd font, rendered on the left columns, while the images themselves are rendered in the terminal to the right. I used to run iTerm, then found Alacrity to be the best when it comes to lean solution, moved to Kitty for speed and landed on Wezterm as the best of all worlds. Like the others, it has its flaws, like the lack of native Windows solution for macOS for example, but nothing I can't deal with to be honest. Since I've been asked a ton of times and the font Wezterm uses is JetBrains Mono, and although GitHub are trying to compete with that with a new set of coding fonts, JetBrains remains my favorite terminal and Vim font. In addition to that, I use Nerd font for icons that I could use both in my plugins and other areas for nice visuals, and Wezterm works perfectly with that. As for the terminal itself, I use ZSH just for simplicity. I don't think it's necessarily the best, but I never had a good enough reason to move, and my tooling is built around ZSH and its capabilities. While Oh My ZSH, probably one of the most widely used projects for terminal lovers, as a prompt for ZSH, I moved about 16 months ago to Starship and honestly never looked back. Not only Starship is faster, it's slimmer, easier to config, written in Rust, and an overall charm to work with. I've got a lot of videos covering both my old ways with Oh My ZSH, but an even more recent one covering my move to Starship, the whys, the hows, and I highly recommend it. You can see how Starship helps with my Git status, it offers even deeper dive when I'm rebasing or cherry picking, it can detect my AWS account, region and profile, as well as my Docker setup, Kubernetes cluster, and a bunch of other plugins. I don't use much of these to keep it simple, and you can catch my configuration on my .files repo right here. As you've probably noticed, the layer above my prompt is Tmux. Tmux is a terminal multiplexer, I went through every bit of it in a bunch of videos, but the most recommended one is the one right here. It'll take you from scratch to beast mode in looks and control of your terminal panes and windows. If you recall, I told you in the beginning that some of the software I use has its blind spots, and that made me cover it with my own open source. Tmux Sessions is one such spot. That's the reason I built Session X, and with other amazing contributors, I keep working and enjoying it. Session X is covered thoroughly in the video up here, and you can see how I use it to create and change sessions, remove, rename, preview, and much, much more. It integrates with tools like Zoxide for smart pass, Tmuxinator for templating your environments, and the amazing contributors I mentioned earlier made sure that it's fully customizable. You can change key bindings, window styles, and every bit of the plugin to suit your workflow and style. Tmux comes with its own native bindings for window creation, renaming, switching, and lots of modifications. While it has somewhat of a learning curve to get into everything, it's fairly easy to get started with, and if you feel it's too much to take, go ahead and give Zsh a quick test. I've got another video covering everything around Zsh right up here. In terms of terminal-based tooling, before I head over to my highlight, among a bunch of others, here are my top CLIs that I cannot live without. Zoxide to begin with, which is a modern Rust alternative to the famous Zsh script, is my path switcher. Put simply, it manages a cache of last visited paths and a scoring system to make guesses on where you want to go. I cannot recommend it enough. If you're unsure or you have multiple paths with ambiguous solutions, it also integrates with FZF. That will help you achieve the destination that you wanted from the get-go. By the way, if you read the documentation, it goes through all the options and everything you need to know. Beyond Zoxide, I use many modern alternatives, which for some reason are all Rust-based, like FD, Dog, Bat, and Ezza. Instead of CD, for example, I use a combination of CD and EZA to make everything more readable and navigatable. I use FZF extensively for all my fuzzy findings requirements, and I made a video about that as well. For code searching, I mostly use the RG as it's best in class, and its speed will never disappoint you when searching for text. My CD alias mentioned earlier can be seen here, and it's also on my .zshrc on the .files repo. L stands here as another alias for EZA list, showing beautiful icons and the Git status. Just to showcase some icons and the Git options, check out how every file is covered, from log files through Git ignores, the Git folder, and even Nix flags are all presented nicely. Touching one file is added as the Git status of N, indicating a new untracked file, and a notification to one of them shows up next to the file with a blue M, indicating it was modified. EZA is also capable of showing a nice tree, replacing the native command tree with a refreshing look. And I have an alias mapped to LT, which is roughly the same as L mentioned earlier, but with the EZA tree flagged enabled. We touched FZF or FZF depending on your side of the pond, so bear with me while I switch back and forth. This fuzzy finder is one of the absolute best things you can add to your workflow. I'm using it multiple times a day when searching through my history of commands, but it's also handy when running through files in a directory when you need the quick fuzzy picker. The pick can then be piped over to something like xargs, which can load it into Neovim, for example. I covered Tmux session X earlier, which by the way is using FZF's ability to show up in a pop-up with preview, different selections, and a customizable window. This is all FZF, and it goes way just beyond a fuzzy picker. I got a video covering everything with the features and options you want to set up, it's up here. When it comes to the terminal, there's nothing like a good TUI. These are the terminal user interfaces. We've seen Yazi earlier, and here's LazyGit, one of the tools I use for Git operations. And the same author had also created LazyDocker that covers running containers and debugging them through a UI of its own. I covered both LazyGit and LazyDocker in this video up here around Neovim Git integrations. Speaking about Neovim, the cherry on top of this entire setup is without a doubt Neovim. Most of my channel, if I'm honest, is covering Neovim's features, plugins, setups, and other content. But here's the gist of it. Neovim is where I spend most of my terminal hours, mostly for coding and writing text, but also reviewing changes and organizing local files and configurations. Notable plugins I can't live without are Telescope, which is an internal fuzzy picker based on FZF and helps with files, live grepping for code, buffers, and even integrates with other plugins, like Trouble, for example, to show markers I left in the code, mentioning bugs, to-do items, and more. Beyond the essentials, there are other niche but cool plugins that are a huge help when trying to focus, like Zen Mode and its pair Twilight, which I mostly use for writing text as shown in the video above, but also when focusing on coding tasks. It's also crucially important to mention the messages popping from the language server, running in the background and shooting live messages to me as I make mistakes in my code and suggesting fixes. This is a simple one for shell scripts, but there are LSPs for pretty much every language you can think of. If you want a package manager to install and find them, I highly recommend Mason. I'll leave a link below. My entire Neovim setup is covered in a video which should be released in a matter of days, so make sure you're subscribed to the channel and get notified when it comes out. As you've probably seen, I'm very passionate about my environment and tooling. One thing to remember is when starting to configure your space is the risk of overwriting things. While I think I don't have any hope, I started creating content just to justify the hours I spend here. So I want to be fair and tell you to take everything with a grain of salt. This is an endless world with endless bits of new tooling coming out all the time. If you're having fun, be my guest. But if you feel like you don't, just chill. Lastly, as you've seen, I take everything to the terminal, including my writing, which I do a lot of, for journaling, newsletters, blogging, and mostly for my daily notes. And for that, I use the greatest note-taking integration in existence that has truly, truly changed how I work, and it's right here in this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next one.